If you want to know the best buddy movies, you should definitely watch our picks for the best ones of the 2010s.
You're just going to be scissoring a different girl.
Dude, scissoring is not a thing.
Don't knock it until you've tried it.
Thing.
Don't knock it until you've tried
I'm
it.
I'm not knocking it, but
how about you
not
don't knock it until you tried it?
We hope you will enjoy the following ranking. Please let us know your favorite in the comments and make sure to subscribe to never miss a good movie again.
Number 10. Booksmart.
Missed ya.
I missed you. I missed you so much.
Been one night.
Booksmart is a 2019 coming-of-age comedy film directed by Olivia Wilde and stars Beanie Feldstein and Catelyn Dever. The story follows two academic superstars and best friends who, on the eve of their high school graduation, suddenly realize that they should have worked less and played more. Viewed as pretentious by and determined never to fall short of their peers, the ladies started on a mission to cram 4 years of fun into one night.
Ladies, it's the last day. You know, we did it, huh? We got you through high school. Can't we just graduate, head off to college, you know, celebrate this wonderful achievement, and let's focus on getting through the rest of the day without anything
horrible
happening.
I'm sorry, are you shutting
happening,
the door on us? Because that's not settled. We will persist.
Number 9. 21 Jump Street.
The mission is this: infiltrate the dealers, find the supply.
We get to be brothers?
Infiltrate the dealers, find the supply.
21 Jump Street is a 2012 buddy cop action comedy film directed by Phil Lord and Christopher Miller and stars Jonah Hill, Channing Tatum, Brie Larson, Dave Franco, and Ice Cube. High school is not easy, especially for victims of bullying. But when years after graduation, famous school bully Jenko and his victim Schmidt both become police officers, creating a friendship in police training school. Now they have to investigate a high school to find the dealers of a new drug, clearly underestimating how school has changed.
Those are goths. Those are nerds. I don't know what they are.
What the fuck are those things?
I'm so confused right now.
Number 8. The Guard.
I'm sorry, what? I thought only black lads were drug dealers and Mexicans. What did I call them? Do I have a word for them?
Yeah, there's a word for you too, sir.
The Guard is a buddy cop comedy film written and directed by John Michael McDonough and stars Brendan Gleeson, Don Cheadle, and Liam Cunningham. Violent, cynical, and filled with dark humor and blood-cracking jokes, The Guard is a buddy cop thriller with all the right ingredients to leave a mark in the genre. When a vulgar Irish cop and a heated US FBI agent have to work together, they uncover a potential corruption among officers while on the hunt for a drug cartel.
These men are highly dangerous.
And if mules. You are... Drug mules.
That's enough for your guff now, Boyle. Apologize to the man.
Huh? Apologize for what?
You know for what?
For your racist slurs, for one thing.
I'm Irish, sir. Racism is part of my culture.
That's enough now.
Number 7. The Nice Guys.
I was in the pool.
You were in the pool?
Yeah.
Why?
I had to question the mermaids.
The Nice Guys is a neo-noir action comedy film directed by Shane Black and stars Russell Crowe, Ryan Gosling, Anjari Rice, Matt Bomer, and Margaret Qualley, proving that the brilliant Shane Black buddy movie formula still offers fresh wind with cynical humor, hilarious action, and purely lovable characters. The Nice Guys is everything and more you would want from a funny and harsh modern film noir. When a douchebag of private investigator and a reckless goon team up to lift a porn industry conspiracy, everything can and will go wrong.
Let's get rid of this guy.
Oh, God.
Number 6. The Peanut Butter Falcon.
You have a young boy with Down syndrome in the middle of nowhere.
I'm the one that's been taking care of him because he can't do it unless you put him in a cage.
The Peanut Butter Falcon follows the life of Zach, a young man with Down syndrome who escapes from a retirement home to pursue his dream of becoming a wrestling champion. Directed by Tyler Nelson and released in 2019, the comedy drama film stars Shia LaBeouf, Dakota Johnson, and Zach Gottsagen in lead roles. Despite a limited theatrical release, the movie was a box office success and received positive reviews from the critics and audience alike.
I'm sorry to break up your little primitive gang or whatever is going on, but this is not Lord of the Flies. You can't just... There's rules, there's regulations,
okay.
He has medication, there's paperwork.
Yeah, all right, well, while you've been doing paperwork, we've been doing something called living. Ain't that right, bud?
Yeah.
Number 5. End of watch.
Who's a cowboy?
I don't know. He's got money. Look at his truck. Want to run him.
You want to jam this fool?
Yes, I do.
End of Watch is a 2012 American action thriller film written and directed by David Ayer and stars Jake Gyllenhaal and Michael Peña. In Los Angeles, street cops Brian and Mike are partners, balls-out cowboys patrolling the streets as Latino gangs are in a power struggle with blacks. But when Mike and Brian find a great load of drugs and people involved in human trafficking, they are sentenced to death by the cartel. Can the two police officers escape the cartel's murderous reach?
Oh, shit.
What the fuck is it?
Homeboy's a player, dude.
We got a surprise for you.
Liberace's AK.
What?
Number 4. 50-50.
What's it called?
Schwannoma. I knew this.
Schwannoma?
Schwannoma.
It's Schwannoma? What's Schwannoma?
That means tumor, basically.
50-50 is a black comedy drama film directed by Jonathan Levine and stars Joseph Gordon-Levitt, Seth Rogen, Anna Kendrick, and Bryce Dallas Howard. Taking on a very serious topic, but with such lighthearted attitude that it becomes an instant classic, 50-50 is the tragic story of Adam, who is diagnosed with deadly cancer. Now having a 50-50 chance of survival, he fights his troubles by seeing a psychiatrist with whom he falls in love. Now their bond threatens to destroy more than just a professional relationship.
Every celebrity beats cancer.
Fucking Lance Armstrong, he keeps getting it.
Yeah.
He's fine.
Yeah.
Guy from Dexter, he's
right.
Okay. Patrick Swayze, he's fine.
Patrick Swayze?
And he's older.
Yeah, but dude, that guy's dead.
Number 3. Hunt for the Wilder People.
Faulkner is Caucasian. Well, they got that wrong because you're obviously white.
Hunt for the Wilder People is a 2016 New Zealand adventure comedy drama film written and directed by Taika Waititi and stars Sam Neill, Julian Dennison, Rhys Darby, Rima T. Wiata, and Rachel House. Ricky, a juvenile criminal, is abandoned by his mother and taken in by the child services. He is then adopted by Bella and Hector, a country couple who managed to get through to him. However, when an unexpected tragedy hits the family, Ricky must escape child services by traveling through the wild bushes of New Zealand.
Oh, Uncle, you're basically a criminal now. But on the bright side, you're famous.
I think I'm crazy.
And Asian.
Number 2. The Grand Budapest Hotel.
Have you ever been questioned by the authorities?
Yes, on one occasion.
What?
I was arrested and tortured by the rebel militia after the desert uprising.
Right. Well, you know the drill then. Zip it.
The Grand Budapest Hotel is a 2014 American-German comedy-drama film written and directed by Wes Anderson and stars an ensemble cast consisting of Ralph Fiennes, Tony Revolori, Matthew Amalric, Adrian Brody, Willem Dafoe, Jeff Goldblum, Harvey Keitel, Bill Murray, Edward Norton, and Saoirse Ronan. Set in the fictional war-torn European country Zubrowka in the 1930s, the movie tells the story of a concierge and a lobby boy as they team up to prove the concierge's innocence after being framed for murder.
I hereby place you under arrest for the murder of Madame Celine Villeneuve de Coffin Taxis.
I knew there was something fishy. We never got the cause of death. She's been murdered. And you think I did it.
Before we unveil movie number 1, here are a few honorable mentions.
What about me, Frank?
What do you mean, what about you?
If you die eating cheeseburgers, what do you think happens to me? I'll have failed. They'll send me back to the warehouse and wipe my memory.
When I get back home, I'm gonna show Sarah how much I care about her every single day. Whenever she wants, she's thirsty or whatever, she can drink my spit, and then she can ride my gas to wherever she wants to go.
You can't use your gas in front of other people.
What? Why not?
Yeah, we're gonna go back to Newton Haven.
Why?
For some unfinished business.
That's a joke, right?
Five guys, 12 pubs, 50 pints.
60 pints.
Oh, steady on your fucking alky.
I haven't had a drink for 16 years, Gary. You must be thirsty then.
Number one. Green Book.
As I'm writing this letter, I'm eating potato chips, and I'm starting to get thirsty. You know this is pathetic, right?
Green Book is a 2018 biographical comedy-drama film directed by Peter Farrelly and stars Viggo Mortensen, Mahershala Ali, and Linda Cardellini. Inspired by a true story, the working-class Italian-American bouncer Tony Vallelonga becomes the driver and bodyguard of an African-American classical pianist on his concert tour through the Deep South in the 1960s. Despite their different personalities, the two men soon build a deep friendship while confronting discrimination and racism.
So that little temper tantrum, was it worth it? You never win with violence, Tony. You only win when you maintain your dignity. Dignity always prevails.
Do you agree with our list? Please let us know in the comments. If you want to know more about a particular movie in this list, you can check out our links in the video description. And for more top 10 movie videos, be sure to subscribe to communiTV.